So hey everybody, I'm Steffen, I'm a neuroengineering student at Technical University of Munich, and I will talk a bit about training deep neural networks on little amount of labeled medical data and what we can do to actually exploit the properties we have in medical data sets. So when you go out at noon and observe objects in nature, let's say a leaf, which is quite difficult right now given the weather, but anyway, it will appear green. When you see the leaf in the evening, it will still appear green, which is kind of strange because the power spectrum of the wavelength spectrum is actually completely different. So there's some normalization mechanism in the brain going on that takes high-level features or high-level context information in order to alter the perception. And we tried to do something similar for medical images. So recent developments in deep learning have developed something which is called autistic style transfer, which was first introduced by Leon Gattis from the Bethke Lab in Tübingen 2 years ago. And the basic idea is to transfer the style of a style image by a painter, for example, to a photograph you have taken. And the intuition is kind of that you preserve the content information you have in your image or in your signal in general, and you kind of remove all the style information from that image and you modulate style information from the style image onto your content. And what drops out is basically an image painted in a particular style of an artist. And we tried to use a similar technique for the so-called problem of domain adaptation, which is quite prominent in medical imaging. Because when you think about how medical data sets look like, it's usually that you have quite a lot of sample bias, and a small data set cannot cover all the variants you have in your data set. So as you can see at the lower right, is an example where a simple linear classifier is fitted to a training data set, which is quite small. And you can see that although the classifier perfectly separates the two data sets, when you now want to transfer it on the test set, which has kind of a little bit of shift in the distribution, this causes a lot of wrong samples. So ideally, we want to come up with a mechanism that can somehow detect this shift in domains and normalize the images while preserving the content information. So how does this relate to medical imaging? In the lab where I did this work, the basic goal was basically to develop a robust mechanism for semantic segmentation of histological slides, which is kind of gigapixel microscopy images of stained tissue slides. And the challenge here is that when you get data from different labs or even different just different microscopies, the color variance is quite a problem when you want to apply the same classifiers. As you can appreciate on the right side, we recorded a data set where we kind of tried to preserve the content per tissue patch by slicing one block of tissue and staining it with different protocols to somehow simulate the variance you can have. And to basically overcome this problem of different stain, which is dependent on the classes. So a tumor, for example, reacts different to the stains than blood vessels, for example. We deployed a deep neural network that basically computes the features at each point using a quite high-level feature representation, and then uses this feature representation to normalize the positions which have kind of similar feature properties, using the framework of style transfer. So in a sense, we are solving pretty much the same problem. We want to preserve the content information, which is the tissue classes present in the image, but we kind of want to render images from other labs as if they were recorded with our own equipment. So this works quite well and is also beneficial for training classifiers in general. As you can see on the left side, we conducted an experiment on some sort of benchmark data set in histology. And you can see that the data set processed with feature-aware normalization kind of has a better separation of different classes, which are different denoted by different colors here. And it's thus a bit easier to train classifiers because you waste less computational power On actually discriminating between the different color variants because you have completely removed it beforehand. So I'm currently looking to apply this approach also to other kinds of data, which are also hopefully more challenging than just color normalization, which is currently brain-computer interfaces. So if you're working on data sets for which this methodology might be interesting, I'm happy to welcome you at Postdoc 28. Thanks.